Bosley. As there's the thud, and all of you guys turn over there. And then, like, the spider moves or something like that. Makes a wise crack.
About the thud?
About the Ewok being crushed by the body parts.
Well, you don't see that every day.
Everyone's heads turn back.
Right? That's not normal now, is it?
Turns back towards the 8 foot tall, 8 foot diameter.
Oh, right. He's gigantic.
Beast. I mean, he's not super gigantic, but he's definitely 2 feet taller and quite a bit wider than everyone else. Just standing there, just chilling out. I promised I would explain what the hell that. Who the hell Bosley is.
Oh, yeah, that's important.
We didn't really get into it. So Bosley, what ultimately ended up happening to Bosley was in, and you guys can listen to episode 3, Pit of Despair, to find out all about this.
Right.
Got kidnapped by the Imperials.
Uh-huh.
After teaming up with another person. Got imprisoned in their maximum security prison, the Pit.
The Pit, yeah. The
Planetentiary. And ended up basically helping a big escape attempt. But not everybody got out, and one of the people that didn't get out was Bosley, who had to stay behind as the place went self-destruct and everyone else flew off.
Yeah.
But that happened off-screen.
Yeah.
So I think he survived in some sort of horrible form, but something happened at some point to get you from there, your presumed death state, here in a different part of space where only your brain is alive. But none of these people know you or know anything about you, and you might be a horrible threat.
Yeah. You say I don't have a face anymore?
Yes. Would you like to have your actual head?
I would.
Okay, I'm fine.
That way
you
can make sarcastic expressions.
Well, I only said brain because that's the spider bots with brains floating in globes is part of Star Wars
it is.
Lore.
Okay,
that's in Jabba's palace. But if you want it to be a whole head,
I do, but I don't want to break lore.
What if it's just your head?
I will. In this case, since we are murdering Gippy clones, I think I'll allow you to bend lore.
Fair enough.
A little bit.
Cool.
What were you thinking?
Oh, no, just saying, what if it is your head, but it's just frozen in a state of, like, pain and
Erictus.
Like hey, guys, how's it going?
Like Stephen Hawking.
Yeah, it was sort of, I guess, yeah.
Yeah. But can talk.
Gross.
Would you say he could manhandle lore?
Yeah, no,
let's
got
continue
it.
The
got
game.
Got it.
Tom walked out.
I was walking out
Don't
of the
come
room.
Back.
Okay.
In victory. False victory. False victory.
James B. 1971 gives a reroll to Terry.
No!
Thank you.
Thanks, James B.
And Sci-Fi T-Rex.
Sci-Fi
Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex gives a reroll to me.
Oh.
Yes! I love those rerolls. They are the best. Okay. It is Bosley's turn. What would he do?
So he was a mechanic. He still is in some way or another because he built this body for himself. So he's a very cold and calculated person, especially because of all the things he's been through. So he doesn't even look at you. He just sees these rampaging clones, two left, I believe.
Only two left.
Pops up this turret out of his body that's going, gets a bead on them and just fires.
At the clones?
Yeah.
Love it. Okay. Roll to hit, I guess.
Okay.
It's just two purple against your... So you have a gun turret
light.
Built into you, huh?
Yes, yeah. Built into my body.
Gotcha.
Is range light? Oh, it's just two green and a yellow, and I will boost it to make it two yellow and a green against two purple. Any boost from you?
No boost from me.
Okay.
I'm happy with you doing
it. Oh, I do have a boost also, so I guess that's on any roll I choose that you said
anytime,
that?
Yeah, it hangs around.
Okay, this is fine. Floating. I don't need it for this one.
Okay. So the last two Gippies, freed of all other, and seemingly, I don't know, they probably would flee at this point.
Oh, a triumph. Mm. Oh, a fail.
A fail with a triumph. Great, so you open fire, so whatever happens, you miss them.
Okay.
How many failures is it?
It is one failure left after the cancels.
Any threat?
No.
Okay,
one advantage.
Okay, great.
And one triumph.
So failure, gun jams.
The gun jams. I'm not
like
as him? Good a mechanic. No more, opposable thumbs.
It's hard to get to your own turret.
Yeah.
Yeah, you had somebody else install that one. I'm gonna say take one wound.
Take a wound. Okay.
Yeah, it was clone juice was in the barrel or something like that.
Sure. Yeah.
There's just like a.
So I'm at 9 now, Dom, for wounds.
God dang it.
Yep. Wake up and do your job. Thanks, Tom.
Hurt again. Oh, no.
He can manhandle lore.
Don't make that a thing.
Writing that down, I'm sure.
So what do you do with your triumph, however?
Oh, what do I do with my triumph? So I don't shoot them, but I get a triumph. Oh, what could happen? My gun jams. Maybe they recognize me.
The Bindoos you were trying to shoot.
Yeah, I've killed quite a few of these now. At this point,
you've been fighting your way through this facility,
and maybe they have some sort of hive mind, so they've been like telling each other.
Seems believable.
Watch out for that spider guy. So they kind of.
Watch out for that spider guy. They just. That's our trap.
That's the only.
A trap.
It works.
That's the only thing
time.
They can say to one another.
Like that, their Pokemon style.
Yeah. That's our trap. That's our trap.
So they just turn and run. That's what I'll say.
Okay. That works for me for a triumph.
Cool.
Running, of course, being a very generous
right.
term for
shamble.
What a 400-pound 80-year-old man does, 90-year-old man.
I can't believe they cloned him into the 90-year-old version of him. They didn't, like, nope. down-age yeah. him for the clone. They're like, actually, now let's go straight to the end.
Well, all these clones look a little bit different. There seems to be quite a bit of variance between the clones. So, I don't know. Maybe they did clone some other ones, too. We'll find out.
Uh-oh.
So you're chewing your way out.
I'm eating my way out. I'm not minding
nothing
it too
much. Nothing as satisfying as just having a bunch of raw fish jammed in your mouth and just no choice but to just chew on it.
Like, Root's always been like real reluctant to try sushi, but like candy. Once she tried it, she liked it.
Yeah, as long as the sushi was like a cognizant creature that had thoughts and feelings.
I know this thing that I heard it talk. Yum.
Yeah, and probably the pain and fear it felt as it was pleading for its mother.
Yes.
As you were stabbing it in the net makes it all the richer.
Get a spicy Gippy roll. It's delicious.
Yeah,
a little spicy.
I mean, the tears are basically the same liquid as the blood, so it's
so Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex adds three more bad Bindoos.
Bad Bindoos.
Right. So you guys all breathe a breath of relief, and then that is when.
Wait, have I eaten my way out yet? Do I need to roll and see how long it takes me to eat my way out?
No, this is before that even. Is your You're an Ewok. You're this big.
Yeah.
it defies imagination to imagine you eating one, let alone eight.
Don't underestimate Root.
My dog once ate a ham the size of her, and her stomach just swelled up, and then she just went and sat in a corner for 3 days and digested. That's what I'm doing.
Oh, poor Doodles.
I really wondered how she was not throwing
up. Okay, so it's going pretty well, and you're feeling great. Your belly swollen, but you're like, I got this.
You see that article about the penguin? It's just like, penguin eats all fish, like refuses to mate, socialize.
Like me! Dude, I'm fucking fish.
It's just, picture this penguin that's just huge. Alone.
I understand that penguin.
Is this in the zoo or in the wild?
I think it was the wild, actually.
Wow.
That's my new favorite penguin. My previous favorite penguin was the one from the Werner Herzog documentary where he goes to Antarctica. And he's doing that. He's talking about how sometimes penguins just go, fuck it. So there's this, everyone should watch this documentary. But it's like, so there's like a line of like 12 penguins and he's just filming them. And they're all just going for like from their little roost out to the sea to go and get fish. And like one penguin, like seven deep, just stops and turns towards the mountains. Just these mountains that are just hundreds of miles away. And just starts going for it. And like everyone else just like keeps going and he's just like, fuck it, man. To the mountains. And apparently they do that sometimes. Sometimes they just are like, fuck it, I'm going to the mountains. And like people who research penguins will like go and like grab the penguin sometimes, bring it back and put it in line, and it'll be like, no. And it'll just go, it's not confused. It's out of here,
man.
Made
a choice.
New favorite penguins. Yeah. Penguin talk. High five.
Thanks. Penguin Sorry, talk. Didn't mean to derail the podcast.
No, again. Not to derail it, but you feel six hands grip you from below.
From below?
Yeah, so you're still...
No!
You're
still, I'm on top of Gibby!
You're still being crushed beneath this pile. You guys are like, she'll eat her way out. You hear the munching sounds coming.
That's normal.
What you don't notice is that it's that kind of like catwalk-style slotted grates that you would have where there's crawl space beneath. And you just feel somehow, as you're crushed, you can't see anything. Fluids are flowing over you. Hands grab you. And then the support... flooring that you're on gives away and you're pulled down into a pit, and of course the hundreds of pounds of chopped up man follow,
I am really feeling you are trying very hard to kill me now.
That was a donation by Darth Sci-Fi Tracks.
I appreciate that. Whoa. Thank you.
Three bad Bindoos.
Sci-Fi T-Rex.
You guys up on, so you are essentially pinned.
Bring it.
The other Bindoos who are down with you are basically, I think you guys are all mashed up against each other.
Do I take more strain or wounds for this fall?
No, because they're soft enough that you're
soft,
not going to.
Soft, cushiony.
Oh.
Do any of the
you take a strain because
Bindoos on top of me slide off?
No.
No.
No, no, they slide on top of you.
No, they come down, but like we're now a pile of Gippy Bindoos on a new floor with a soft base. Almost, some just, of them slide.
You're like in like a crawl space, so it's like almost like you're just in like
okay.
a crawl you're
space.
In like a grave. You're in a grave.
I'm in a Gippy Bindoo grave.
Yes, but instead of dirt, it's filled with Gippy Bindoo parts.
This is actually, this is something that came up in the lore back on.
Good.
Back on my home planet. Like, this is like, oh, if you're really bad in your life, you will be buried in a grave full of like, slimy but delicious things.
Oh, my God. Well, then it is coming true.
It's still a pretty sweet religion, I guess. So, like, you know.
You're kind of like mashed in.
Oh, yeah.
Upside down at an angle, feet up above you, arms at a weird angle.
It's so hard to eat my way out.
And the Gippies are mashed in next to you as well, and you can feel like the live ones, or maybe they're the dead ones, are kind of like working their fingers on your like face and like someone's gnawing on one shoulder. You guys up on the surface just hear the thunk, and you turn over and you just see the slope of Bindoos just kind of down, and now it's kind of formed an inverse kind of cone. And you can, deep down in this mash, hear. Killing. Your root. On the other hand, we do have BSB Care gives one reroll to root. Did I give you that?
No. Yay!
Yay!
Thank you, BSB Care!
Thanks, BSB Care.
Sorry, my bad. Awesome. And oh, Darth Sci-Fi Trex? T-Rex?
T-Rex.
Yes, Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex. I also saw your original donation and I'm saving it for the sweetest moment. So just let me sit on that for a minute.
Oh, dear.
What would you guys do up top as you see that? You guys all get a chance to act before you. And I mentioned it for a second, but you take some strain.
Yeah, so that's okay. Another one strain or two?
Oh, that was a pretty bad crit. So let's say it keeps increasing. So take two strain this time.
So what are you at now?
I'm at eight.
Ooh.
Eight.
Yeah, you've got like one of the severed Bindu heads is like right in that wound.
Ouch.
His teeth are grinding in.
No.
Beak.
Owie.
Yeah, that's gross. Okay, what would you guys do? Out of order. No other Gindus? No other Bindus seem to be coming into the room.
Just put my turret away.
Problem solved.
I start spinning up my chain, like, and it's like, well, it's like, you know, I'm adept with this and with food processors, so this might be helpful. So, like, walk over to, like, the pit, right? And just, like, the swirling chain, just slowly lower it down so it just starts pureeing.
Talking about a spicy Bindu roll.
Yeah.
Just, so it's just like, it's slowly, though, so it's just creating a fine layer of slush that keeps rising as, like, it.
How do you not hit
through the faces of the
nimble. I assume the Ewok's pretty nimble.
You can dodge this, right?
Okay, well, I do think we need a roll for that. So you're definitely going over there and doing it, but I want to see if you screw up and end up slicing a leg off or something like that.
Oh, great.
No, not my legs!
Either
my delicious
either
legs.
Yours or hers, who knows?
Okay, so what would that be?
It sounds like a... okay, so he gets two yellow and two green on his, on his melee check.
Mm-hmm.
Against... Oh...
Let's here's what I'm thinking, though.
One red.
Yeah, it can't be that hard because as the weight of Gippy Bindoos on me lessens, I have more ability to like wiggle around and indicate my location.
Yeah, and it's taking his time.
Wait, is Paul Lynde a bad guy?
kind of.
Yeah,
he's certainly
questionable.
He certainly wants to make sure that you guys hunt down your former friend and bring her into justice.
He put a collar on me.
And he collared you.
Yeah.
Poland. Yeah.
A good collar?
No.
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 Bad collar.
A like shock collar.
Oh, okay.
So let's see what happens here.
Uh oh, that's a failure.
I fail.
Why don't you re-roll that?
No,
here you go.
Oh, what? I get to use it?
Re-roll! Oh, it's as good as I hoped.
Despair.
No. See, there.
Okay,
that
there
was a good
go.
Use of a re-roll.
That was a great use of a re-roll.
All right.
In fact, it was astounding that you failed. Because you were rolling so many dice.
Yeah, that's true. It truly was, but
so that's
it's a miracle.
Success,
four success.
Three advantage.
Three success, four advantage.
Yeah, so three success, four advantage.
That might be a crit.
Wow.
That might be, yeah.
I don't know what kind of weapon this is, but...
Gippy Bindoos. So crit around me.
That would take care of the remaining three if we're doing three a success per murder, right? So
this was just to puree your way down to her level.
Oh, okay. I'm
still
sorry.
It's very successful, so he doesn't not, I don't get pureed.
No,
Ewok gets mixed in with the Gippy.
It's almost like you're in a big milkshake. You're just gonna be like,
yeah,
a big person milkshake, except the person who's inside of it, instead of going, no, is going, yeah.
It's just like in all those Star Wars movies.
Get all this in me. Yeah. I love it.
I happened to Attack of the Clones. I remember that. Yeah.
Well, so it's kind of this like crawl space, and all the flooring is kind of loose grating. So. The puree is draining away. You are looking more horrific than you've ever looked in your life. In addition to being covered with slurry, person slurry, you're also like where you were jammed up against people, got all mucusy on you. And so you've got like a big cowlick on one half of your body where your fur has been like mushed up, sticking out.
So can I use my advantage to like restore some strength for a root?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
Thank you.
Great, now that you are out of the crush of
How much do I get back? Strain.
I got four advantage, so.
Wow, I would give you two strain, let's say.
Yes.
Wait, what were you down on strain?
I was down to eight. So now I'm back
down
up to ten.
Strain, not wounds?
No, I was down in strain, not wounds. So I was down to eight strain, and now I'm back up to ten strain.
Gotcha.
Someone it really wasn't. This guy.
Let me know if it's hit points or strain.
Okay, yeah, we'll do.
Sorry.
So the mush drains away, leaving you, but also, yes, you had to say?
I was going to say, are not also the three other Gippy Bindoos down here drinking the Gippy Bindoos slurry?
Yeah, that's where they are. They're all on their hands and knees going, no, no.
Yeah. It's just like in that scene in A New Hope. Like, what an interesting smell you've discovered. And then he gets out a crazy straw and starts drinking the garbage water, right? Am I the only one who remembers that?
Yep.
Great job keeping this in canon, David.
Yeah. Just before George Lucas messed with the special editions.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
The original had that. I remember it.
I did that scene where Han just starts drinking.
Han shoots first and drinks garbage water.
Yeah. Just puckers up and just goes. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. We're having fun tonight. No, that is a good question. I think the other Gippies are just standing there horrified would maybe make some amount of sense.
Are they? Are
they're not standing. They're underneath me, right?
No. They were underneath you. That's right. So they are.
They'd have to drink some slurry.
Yeah, they would.
They definitely, at least inadvertently, fill their stomachs with the slurry of their clone brother.
It was like three successes, hoping they'd drown on the slurry of their comrades.
I'll give them
like in Star Wars.
I'll give them some setbacks. Kaveri and Bosley, you guys each have a chance to act here.
Yes, I would like to. I feel like I got a rope with me. I feel like I got something like with me that I'm going to throw down.
Great. Yeah, the Gippies immediately go, oh, thank you.
No. And I shake
them
off. This is for Root!
We're drowning in our brothers!
And she's eating us! We're the hunted!
Okay, so you will have to fight them for the rope.
Fine, what do I roll? I'll fight them for the rope.
You could just squirm past them with a coordination check. That's fine. Or you could, if you want to literally fight them, it would be an opposed brawl check.
A coordination check?
Oh, is it called coordination, yes?
No.
Yeah, coordination.
Where? Oh, there it is. Okay, good. I'm good in that.
I'm not insane, right?
No,
yeah. I didn't see it. I didn't see it. Now I do.
I was in the wrong.
I admit it.
Given that they're in a hole and there's like a whirling thing of death coming towards them, wouldn't it be more accurate just to say it's a trap over and over?
You're right. I'm sorry. I forgot the one thing I assumed. The one thing you stated about them.
It literally is like,
it's a trap!
Yeah, it is. Really, it is.
It's a trap! Wait, are you still spinning the blade down towards
them? Of course.
Well, then she cannot get
I
that
could
rope
not
in.
Get a rope down there, then.
Unless
well,
you just
I mean,
chuck it in
I don't
and
know. Paul Lynde's pretty deft at like making sure. I'll just avoid that rope. Okay. Check this one out.
Just climb up past the spinning blades.
I'm really good at hog tying in rodeos. Don't ask me why.
I'd like to just push everybody into this hole.
I do not
want to
know why.
Just shove everybody into this pile.
What?
Mission accomplished.
So Pauline is going to continue spinning the blade as Root tries to climb out?
Yeah.
Okay, great. I love it.
Wow.
What am I rolling against?
Okay, this is just for the Gippies to climb out. I'm going to change my mind then. So this isn't an opposed roll to beat the other Gippies, because the other Gippies are, in fact, at this point going, it's a drop! It's a drop! It's a drop!
Yeah,
so this is a coordination check to avoid getting sliced up by the spinning blade.
Okay.
And you're really good at that.
Yeah.
Three purple. You're pretty small, so take a boost.
I'm going to go ahead and boost.
And take a boost die on it, because... Yeah, oh, we should cheers, by the way, when we flip those over to celebrate using the force. Does anyone have a really great thing?
It's a trap!
It's a trap!
It's a trap!
Oh, careful there.
Nice.
Whoa, okay. Buddy, don't spill too much water on the table. kind of an amateur move.
Yeah.
That's an inside joke, everyone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
It's real inside.
And a boost for being small?
Because you're small, so it's
I'm
a little
small.
Easier.
I mean, I'm a little bigger now that I've been eating Gippy Bindoos.
Oh, yeah. Distended belly now.
Oh, yeah, so take a setback, too, because you do have a big distended Gippy belly.
Okay, so I've got a green and two yellow, a boost, a setback, and three purple. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's do this. Get out of the pit of Gippies.
Looks good.
Yeah.
Success.
You yip at me. I said it looks good.
Okay. So it's...
It's three success.
I gotta just get this out. And then that cancels. Okay. Yeah, it's three success.
Wow. And no threat?
No threat.
Wow.
No threat.
Okay. You nimbly climb out. You barely lose any hairs. Just a couple. Just trimmed.
Those were my favorite hairs.
Just trimmed, though. Okay. Just as you basically are climbing out past this like whirling blade.
Didn't want to say anything, but you needed a trim.
Sergeant Johns. And then the other three are left down there going,
yeah.
You know, we just finish them off, or what would you do?
They're, yeah. See you, boys.
That's a trap.
It does sound like that. Yes, as their heads are just disintegrated by a food processing blade. That's exactly what happens. Great.
Peter Jackson's
Star Wars. Peter Jackson's Star Wars, yes. Okay, Dojima Detective. This is, I think, the first time you've maybe donated something on one of my streams. I think that's awesome. Adds one good guy. Maybe. So I think there's all that happened. Stepping out around the corner into the room.
He's a good guy.
Gippy Bindu.
What? Does Gippy Bindu count as a good guy now?
Well, I don't know. Maybe.
My goodness, thank you for getting rid of those horrible clones. Unlike I, Gippy Prime, who was born with superior intelligence, physical acumen, and stamina to my original DNA donator. I must applaud you, but it is difficult for me to put both of my hands together at the same time.
Because your belly is so massive and rotund because your arthritis is so bad?
Just simply because I only do that for, like, very special occasions.
It's a mental
And thing. I don't see anyone here that appears to have any sort of nobility, so...
Well, you look suspiciously like everyone else. You're naked.
Right.
But...
Is he a little less chicken-colored?
Yeah, he's definitely less chicken-colored. So he might really be Gippy Prime. Or he might be a cunning clone, but in any case, he doesn't seem to want to eat you immediately.
No, goodness no. Although, if you wouldn't mind giving me some slurry, it is what I've subsisted on since the day I was birthed out of a giant tube. It reminds me of home.
Great. Also, Seldon Arceus?
Seldon
Arceus. Seldon!
What up?
Thank you, Seldon.
Seldon.
Okay, Seldon Arceus heals Garoth by 1 point.
Yes!
I love those.
That's very nice.
Very nice.
Back to full!
Is this some sort of Pavlovian experiment you're running?
Yeah, it really is. What are those beeps?
I think those are donations by XP.
Okay.
It doesn't pop up. It's Revlo.
Those are XP
donations.
That's
not for us. Okay, great.
It's okay. So, everything's fine. I'm at full, Dom. No.
What's that?
Dom.
Yeah, whatever.
I offer this new Gippy Bindu in a sign of trust. I offer my arm hair, my fur is full of slurry, so he can have some slurry.
So you can just suck that slurry out of the Ewok fur?
Yep.
Oh, thank you. Yes, this is. I will try and do this with much decor and care.
But I'm also dripping
out of his nose.
No mating in here. No mating.
I need to sit down. No. Oh, I've been sitting down.
Well, Bosley, actually speaking of that, you know of a there's a chamber not too far from here. You weren't able to get to it before because this hole, it was filled with gippies, but you know that they've been cleared. There's like a safer enclosed space. But you know where it is.
Everyone, follow me. This way. Yes, you too.
Very well. I have decided to follow you.
Where are you taking us?
Somewhere where the clones can't find us.
Except for me.
How can we know you're to be trusted?
How do you know I can trust you? Who are you?
We're looking for Tamaya.
You have force sensibility, right? Yeah. You sense living creatures around you. You get this as you guys are sitting there talking. Mm-hmm. Sorry, not to cut you off. No. We'll jump right back to that. You get that like 50 meters out, no, 30 meters out, mm-hmm. coming in from every side. Sense more gippies. They're everywhere.
More gippies?
This place is overrun.
I'm
or
full.
Creatures of some sort, mm-hmm. but they're alive and they're moving towards you.
Yeah, this place is overrun with creatures. I can sense it. We'll go wherever you take us now. As long as it's away from here.
Okay.
Excellent.
You're looking for Tamaya is where I cut you
off.
Yeah. Okay.
We're looking for Tamaya. Let's walk while we talk.
Yeah. Okay.
We sorkin it as you guys are like quickly walking down the hallway. Low angle shot, pulling back to catch all of your guys.
Gippy cannot quickly walk down any hallway.
Well, yeah. Okay, so front is you two talking.
Do we have a cart to stick a Gippy on?
In the extreme back, we see Gippy like just barely in the shot, struggling to keep up.
I think it just like lashed two of like the torsos.
But just
to the spider creature. He's just riding them, right?
Yeah. So just you're just like water skiing on these two Gippy
exactly,
torsos.
Right.
Why wouldn't
Great.
You? Sure, I agree to that.
Yeah, okay. right, so you guys walk and talk as you guys approach is essentially, it looks like a private quarters of maybe an executive office or something like that, a little deeper into this cloning facility. Yes.
We were looking for Tamaya.
How do you know Tamaya?
Oh, she was with me on ship, talked to herself a lot. Weird lady.
your common is getting better.
It
your
is.
Basic
I
is
let that
better.
Happen because it was really hard to communicate before.
Well, Tamaya saved my life and then almost killed me.
Oh, still weird.
Yes, and so I guess it doesn't make any sense to explain what happened to you because no one knew you before.
That's true, yeah.
Yes.
None of these people knew who I was.
But for the meta commentary then, and just to get it out of the way, possibly you explain this stuff to everyone else at the table. That you are a famous or successful engineer at any point.
I don't think I was famous though, because it was probably like top secret military.
Well,
yeah.
Johnst
stuff.
Would know, or at least have some sort of so let's say meta wise, Johnst that's
might.
Who's being like it's like, mm-hmm. So what's your deal, spider dude?
The name's Bosley Mathis.
That rings a bell. Didn't you blow up Alderaan, you jerk face?
Can spiders cry? I did. But not on purpose. I built that
Aren't
laser.
Aren't you from Alderaan?
Oh, well then it's okay.
Yes. But I didn't build the laser to destroy Alderaan. I built it to fight, you know, threats against the Empire.
Like Alderaan.
Alderaan was a peaceful planet. They didn't do anything.
Sergeant Johnst, if anything, feels you're definitely gung-ho New Republic.
Yeah.
But now that Trumpu the Hutt has been elected as High Chancellor, you're definitely on board with that. So you probably understand the fascist totalitarianism.
That's true.
At heart.
That's true. It's like, well I'll let you slide. I mean, who among us has not genocided somebody?
Me.
Oh, I guess that's just us.
I'm in good company then.
That was Gippy in the back.
Oh. Oh.
More Gippies.
It's a trap! Technically, that was not me. That was my original counterpart. My hands are clean of all atrocities, and I can do no wrong.
That seems untrue. Okay,
so you guys get a little more of the backstory. Briefly, Bosley recounts how he was on this prison planet, this penitentiary.
Night Steeds.
Talking about the Night Steeds.
Night Steeds.
I heard that as Night Steve, which was also very exciting to me. But yeah. Night Steeds is pretty good.
It's also. It's also KN, which is great.
Knight Steeds.
Yes. Okay, so for Knight Steed and for everybody else, you recount how you were on the pit, this place, and it was going self-destruct, and there you were, ready to face the reckoning for your actions as this place was exploding around you.
I deserve to die.
At the last moment found, I don't know what it was, maybe it was an escape pod that would have been used or something like that, or a good closet. Something.
Maybe I'll die better in here.
Somehow using your brilliant engineering mind, you managed to, at the last moment, MacGyver some sort of safe cocoon for Bosley's body.
It's a bunch of posters that said, visit Alderaan, and I'm like, I'm just gonna make a shield out of this.
Locked in your little survival cubby that you had put together, the entire pit exploded around you, this prison complex that's halfway embedded in a lava field on a barren planet in a distant corner of the galaxy. And you survived. Although the explosion, the force of it, almost completely obliterated your body. You were definitely horribly, you were fully Darth Vader'd.
Right.
Burned horribly, but your cubby kept you alive in at least a catatonic state. For however many months it was, months, maybe more than a year, years possibly.
Mm-hmm.
That seems too long, but long enough.
Probably.
Hanging on, months at least. Months until not too long ago, someone came down and finally rescued you, Tamaya. Tamaya left. The very person who you had been sent to the pit to try and rescue, who successfully got out of there, she came back in her personal shuttle looking for something else, but found you instead.
She was looking for Merce.
Yeah, she always does that.
She always looks for her dead husband.
She's crazy. Crazy lady.
Well, why do you want to find her now?
I don't really. Him.
She's a wanted woman.
He's got a collar on me. He made me do things.
What did you do to Root?
He has a remote control mounted to the front of his vest.
I didn't make Root do anything. Where's the kill switch? Well, how do you turn this thing off?
Yeah, take a point of strain as he starts hitting buttons and things start jabbing you in the neck.
Can I try to get this thing off of Root?
Not with him there. He put it on.
Goodness.
Yeah, you're empowered by the Republic to do whatever you want.
Nine strain, Dom.
True, and I'm also empowered to share information when it makes sense. So this is why we're here.
Right, you guys are of course here because Tamaya, right around the time she went off and picked you up, was identified by the New Republic as a traitor, someone willing to commit treason,
right.
Namely turning to the dark side. In particular, trying to resurrect her husband.
Traitor.
So she found you. And in addition, they brought back some genetic material back with them to their base of operations, this very cloning facility.
Right.
In the hope that she could maybe resurrect Merce as a clone. Unfortunately, any remaining genetic material from the pit had all been contaminated, unbeknownst to them, by Gippy Bindu's powerful fluids.
Disgusting.
At the pit. So their cloning got nowhere. In fact, without anyone realizing this, this is what you kind of have pieced together over the last few days. The fluids from the one Gippy clone in the one tube somehow somebody managed to touch it, and a tiny drop got on their fingertip, and then we got a full Jurassic Park type situation where, like, soon every cloning tube was permeated with Gippies, and there's just no way anybody can handle that many Gippies at once.
No way to handle that many
Before the full-scale catastrophe broke loose, Tamaya left. Once again, traveling with her strange dark side guru, this really unusual alien creature, calls himself the Sorcerer of Tund. That's canon. That's on Wikipedia.
It's so close to the Sorcerer of Tund. I'm sorry.
it's T-U-N-D. Oh, iDragon14. A new subscriber!
Hey. Thanks for subbing, iDragon.
Yeah. Thanks for the sub. That's dope.
We do.
Yeah.
We get a free reroll, by the way.
Oh, you do get a free reroll.
And you should give it to somebody.
You should give it to me.
You should not give it to him.
Give it to me.
You should not give it to David.
No, give it to David. He deserves it.
Don't give David anything.
It's four of us.
Reverse psychology, huh? No. Give it to Garov.
Yeah.
No, I was going to legit.
This guy deserves it, huh?
All right. No, legit, there's four of us against one guy.
Yes, give me
that. Yeah, but not really.
Nope.
Because he can make 10 things against us
also,
at the same time.
Did he or did he not just bury me under a pile of Gippy Bindoos?
That was your despair.
And he already said there's a bunch of Gippy Bindoos, I think, all over this building now because all that stuff
bury
got contaminated.
You under a pile of Gippy
Bindoos. About to go against a gajillion Gippy Bindoos right now.
Tamaya left with her strange advisor, the sorcerer of Tund.
Did it escape from its...
Yes. In fact, he seems to be fully corporeal now.
Dadgummit. Tamaya!
After taking over the dead body of General Jandodana. Yeah.
Took over the dead body of General Jandodana?
I did not know that.
Does it still wear a Hawaiian shirt?
That guy's never going to die.
It reformed his corpse to look like it looked in life, kind of with a dark side ritual. So now it is, once again, tall and skinny as a green bean, as red as a drop of blood, eyeless cavities in its face, and this long, thin, snake-like hair as thick as, strands of spaghetti noodles that, goes down its back, black, that kind of waves and moves around. Oh, and his mouth, perfect circle, ringed with, shark teeth, a lamprey's.
Oh, this sounds disgusting.
That's some fucking nightmare fuel, David. What the
hell? Yeah, I'm terrified.
She sounds delicious.
It's the spaghetti hair.
They departed together to an unknown location, and shortly thereafter, the Gippies broke loose. Wham! The doors slammed shut as you guys reached the little safe space office that you are in.
Welcome to my office. I work here.
You do?
What's on your desk?
Do what?
Trying to escape from this hellhole.
What have you worked out?
Not much.
You have found something interesting, though, and that is documents left over by Tamaya on her desk, which seem to indicate her next move.
Ooh.
However,
Merce.
All work and no merce makes Merce a Merce Merce.
Yes.
Tank hides.
Thanks for the follow, Tank Hides.
A follow!
Boom, Tank Hides.
I love it. Okay. You look at it and it just is arcane scrolls and graphs and things like that, and it makes no sense to you. It looks like madness. But even as you take a casual look on it, you recognize this is advanced, secretive force schematics.
Ooh.
This is a deep and secret, complex language that force users would recognize.
This makes sense to you?
It does a little.
A little.
I don't read.
This is. We know, Root. It's okay. This is some. Sorry, Root. I didn't mean to be condescending or anything, but.
Root, does anyone here read ex-wife? I'm sorry, I don't know what the thing is.
But this is some deep force information. This is almost even harder than I can decipher.
It almost is. It's like if you know algebra really well, but then are looking at a calculus equation.
Yeah.
And you're like, okay, that's a plus sign, but I do not know what that thing is over there. You're going to need someone with a little more expertise to figure this out. But what you can actually, give me a check to see how much you can figure out. I would take lore, or in your case, it would be called knowledge.
Knowledge. Not a lot.
Not a scholar. Okay. Against two purple.
All right, we got two green against two purple. And can I use a boost on this just in case?
Yeah. Oh. Use the four.
Dragon 14, really?
What? No, this is a reroll I got.
Gives Garov one reroll.
Oh!
Why, just because I asked for it?
Yep.
But I told you to do that?
Thank you, iDragon 14.
All right.
All right, thank you, Kaveri. So you take a look at it.
Mm. Oh, I succeed.
No.
It's
a big old fail.
Oh, you're right. That's a fail sign. What happened in my brain when that turned into a success?
Called cheating.
Ooh.
I wanted it so much, I saw what I wanted to see. Much
four
like a Trump
advantage,
voter.
Though.
Yeah. It was a fail with
cool. This
with
guy?
Four advantage.
Yeah.
So I could have figured out, okay, but.
We'll give it a minute.
Okay, you got this under control.
Yeah. Yeah, sorry.
Sorry.
Yeah, so you failed?
Yeah, but I had some advantage, too.
Okay.
But I have four advantage, so.
So you can't piece it together. it's beyond you. It was weird that Tamaya was capable of doing this. She's clearly in some weird deep shit. However, there's a couple basic signs you pick up, and what it seems to suggest is something major and something dark side soon. There's like...
This has to do with the dark side, and I think it's going to happen soon.
Something that looks like she was working on. You can't really get the specifics, but it looks like you get a sense of a catastrophic catastrophic event on a galactic scale.
Oh, yeah, this is going to be catastrophic on a galactic scale.
But perhaps I could aid you in translating this document. I'd gladly do so in exchange for a sandwich. I smell them on you. It's technically been my entire life.
It has been my
sandwiches.
It has been my mission to get sandwiches across the entire galaxy.
So you're the perfect person to combat this rising evil.
I think that...
You're allowed to just place it in my hand. I apologize for the profuse sweating. It's just I'm very excited.
Good thing I can figure out if you're going to give me good information or wrong information, right? A little bit of force action.
You hit with the force, roll your force die.
What?
If you get a light side point, you manage to successfully read his mind and not go insane. Dark side point, you become a little more like him.
Whoa! Right.
You managed to shield your mind from the gippiness as you plunge into his psyche. It's like a VR scene from a 1990s hacker movie.
Yes!
Very lawnmower man in Gippy's brain.
Yeah.
And you're trying to tell if he has good info to tell you in exchange for a sandwich? Do you? Or are you tricking her?
I mean, like, I'm sure he believes he does what it's...
I think yes. It seems like he believes he does.
Okay.
So his intentions aren't bad, but he might not even give me good information. Here's a sandwich.
What kind of sandwich is it?
Oh, it's a special meat that I got.
Make our mouths water.
From I don't know.
You can make up anything. Star Wars.
Oh, I got it. I'm just going to make up a planet. I got it from Shutata.
Ooh, Shutata.
Yeah, it's a very special meat. It's from an animal called a gugugugu.
Oh, gugugugu. Yeah.
It's a gugugugu.
That's how you do it.
Yeah.
I know it may seem odd for me to eat a sandwich with a knife and fork, but I just have to... Oh, God. I couldn't resist.
No knife and fork necessary for a sandwich. That's the nice thing about them.
Could you hand me a pencil over there real quick?
Okay, so I'm going to roll. I'm going to then like to roll my one of my knowledge skills.
This would be lore.
It would be lore. Oh dang. Okay.
Are you good at lore?
I have 3 green in it.
Okay.
Ooh.
So this is to try and piece stuff together?
Yes. To maybe get a little bit more information.
Okay.
So you tell me.
That's fair. And I gave you 2 purple?
Yes.
Let's make it 3 purple then. Is it gross? Oh, let's keep it 2 purple, but let's add a black setback. Let's do that instead.
Okay, cool.
Just to, as it's increasingly hard to figure out
boost die on this.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, speaking of which, actually, before I do that, sorry, Knight Steeds gives each player 1 boost die to spend.
Oh, cool.
So you can make a note of that.
Get another boost die here. This is plot info I'm getting.
Thank you, Knight Steeds.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate that.
Knight Steeds.
Oh, listen mama. To the Knight Steeds.
Oh, dear.
That is terrible.
Here.
They roll supposed to be like.
Why are you so nice?
Okay.
Now I have no rerolls.
Yeah,
I have saved my life.
But you do regain 1 strain root from the Bard 1971.
Yes, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.
Oh, I feel better. You know what? Some of the Gippy Bindoos is drying in my fur and it's.
Ugh. Okay, so that's 3 successes and 2 advantage.
Pretty good.
So
3 successes into advantage.
Yeah. So obviously, like in my time, like sending various wayward Jedi to labor camps or whatever whatever experience that Gippy had with Jedi, like mm-hmm. I remember some of this writing.
Yeah.
That, or I just guess and it happens to be right.
Yes.
So holding it upside down.
Okay. So here, what you pick up is advanced force theory, or you make it up as you go along. Okay. But what he relates to you is that dark side and the light side of the force are always contesting with each other in balance, very yin yang sort of thing, right? You can't have one without the other. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And you're piecing it together, and we're getting awesome montage overlays on the screen as you talk.
Yes.
We see the Emperor dying in the second Death Star. And the Emperor, Darth Vader, were like the mouthpiece, where they were the font. They were the steam vent for the dark side. They were a man.
The steam vent.
Yeah, it's like a supercut of all of the stuff from Star Wars with weird dalliances of people drinking garbage water. it's very odd. It's not quite what you remember. Like yes, the dark side and the light side. Yes. And this gentleman and his naughty activities.
Wait, so what? You guys are reading between the lines as Gippy talks about trash water, but it does make sense to you. So with the Emperor gone now, with Darth Vader dead, there's no like mouthpiece for the dark side, and it's been building up. Dark side energy has been beginning to boil up in the galaxy, and it's been looking for an outlet.
Yeah.
And that seems to explain these weird instances that have been cropping up across the galaxy. But all signs point to an eruption. Something's going to happen somewhere, and it's just looking for a focal point. And that's what it seems to suggest. Advantage. You can get a little more information out of this. There's only one person with the expertise in this galaxy who could possibly help you find it. You met him once, long ago. Probably after your training with, remember when you met Luke Skywalker?
Yeah.
And he talked like this.
He's awesome.
It's my favorite form of
Luke
Skywalker.
Lots of power converters.
Yeah. Leia, no, wait for me! That's my favorite Luke. He mentioned to you briefly...
Buy our own ship for that! Anyway, go ahead.
He mentioned to you briefly that there's only one other person in this galaxy who maybe had the level of expertise that Yoda had in the Force. Yoda's younger brother.
What's his name? What's Yoda's brother's name?
Coda?
Doda?
He didn't tell you the name.
Phil.
But he did tell you where he lives.
He hasn't figured it out
where
yet.
He's currently at. No, I know what his name is. I'm just saving it.
Oh, God, it's got to be good.
Gippy Bindoos.
Endor. Yoda's younger brother.
He's on Endor.
Is currently on Endor.
All right.
The sanctuary moon of Endor. Ooh. Also known as the Force Moon.
We've got to get to the Force Moon, yeah. Everyone.
And he was kind of like, and he's a little bit weird. He's not exactly like the other Jedi. He never really bought into the whole Jedi Order thing. He was kind of doing his own Force thing.
He's kind of a maverick.
Yeah, he's kind of a maverick guy.
A little outside.
Which is why he never showed up in the movies.
Off the grid.
Always living in the shadow of Yoda.
It's difficult when Yoda's your brother. I get it.
But you know he's somewhere there on that planet, or on that moon.
Yeah.
And that might be your best chance for figuring out what's going on.
We've got to get to this moon.
I'd like to just get off of this planet.
I wouldn't mind that either right now. It's a lot of Gippies to deal with here.
I vaguely remember that planet. I remember trying to lobby to fumigate it to get rid of all the pests. But yes, I'd love to revisit it. It was beautiful, despite
the
infestation.
Where's your ship? Can we get out of here?
You guys have a ship.
Yeah. I would like to look around this office
technically
for
Paul Lynde's ship now.
Weapons and things I can turn into traps.
Great.
What's in here?
You tell me what's in here. Give me a perception check, and we'll see how good you do. Kaveri, as you guys are going over this, like you suddenly something kind of nags at the back of your mind, and you return to the present moment, and then that sense of those encroaching Bindoos—they're
coming.
They're everywhere, and they're close.
We've got to make it quick. We've got to make it quick.
You're going to have one time for a quick look. So two purple, standard difficulty, but I'm going to give you a bunch of black setback. Well, it depends on how quick you're being. So Kaveri says quick.
We have to go quickly. There's more bad stuff afoot.
Okay, that's one success and three advantage.
So you didn't take any setback on that?
Nope.
Great, which means that she's staying, she's lingering. You guys are like, we have to go. And you're like, wait, let me check this cupboard.
Right route.
A success in what?
Three advantage.
Okay, success means you definitely find stuff. Three advantage means it's three things that would be awesomely useful to you. What are they?
One of those like electric cattle prod things, only like dinosaur strength.
And you've got to explain why all these things were in your office. Dinosaur strength electric cattle prod, yep.
But like, it's got like an 8-foot staff, and it's got a battery pack with 10 charges. Could take down a T-Rex.
Yeah, it says Fucko brand on the side. Yeah, The brand that fucks them up.
Yep, that's the one.
Okay.
A spider has needs.
Okay.
Now that you're a mechanical
needs.
Mechanical robot body, there's one thing, okay.
Okay, my second thing is a steel ball with razor spikes on it that's about 5 feet across and rolls.
You guys didn't notice that when you came in, but it's right next to the chair. It's like right next to the office.
Wow, rude. Do you need some help getting that to the ship?
Okay.
I thought I was a little liberal when I said you find whatever you need in there. I should have speculated that would be in an office.
Too late now.
I was hoping for a space stapler, you know?
Yeah, that's in there.
Swing line.
That's definitely in there.
Yeah. And the third thing will be something that is actually in an office. No, it won't. Okay, a wheeling chair.
I just need
chair.
Paper clips.
A chair with wheels.
My God, when you put all that together, what is it?
It's a wheeling
a
chair?
The chair, but a good one, like a high-end wheelchair. Like, if you were in an office, you could, like, push off on this and just roll forever.
Oh, so it's not a wheelchair, it's like
thank God, I thought
no, it's
it
a chair
was
on wheels.
Office chair
it's a wheelchair.
Great.
Wheelie wheelchairs that would be in an office.
Yeah, you find that in the locked weapon locker that says weapons, and you open that up, and it's just the wheelie chair rolls out. Why does he have a chair?
Why do I have a chair?
It's what was locked up because clearly you don't need
anything
it.
Anything can be a weapon if you throw it hard enough.
Great.
And if you're an 8-foot spider.
And the 5-foot metal ball with spikes that can pop out of it?
I feel like that's self-explanatory. I don't need to explain that part.
That's more of a sex office. I like that.
It's a lonely spider, one safe place.
Oh my God.
Oh boy.
Well, you guys managed to get all that, which is great, but not before Gippies come crashing through the roof. Like the structure, like they must have been in the ducts because they give way with a big creak and then just, they start spilling out, spatting into the, spatting? Pretenders! Splattering into the room. Yeah, they hit and they're just so covered with mucus type fluids, they just blap out.